He will sit there. His young money.
Young money.
Yeah.
Young Moolah, baby!
hey, put that in the Moolah. Put that in the Moolah.
Let's get right into it. Let's get right into this real talk. This is yours truly, Troy, Trent, Kenneth.
They call me XR. XR. Or Ryan Xavier, don't matter.
Alright, cool.
Let's call this nigga Ryan, bro.
No, the homies call me XR though.
XR?
Like, that should sound cooler. I don't know.
It does sound cooler. XR. XR coming. I was like, what the fuck
right.
is that?
And then I was like, that's real. Yeah. I feel like Dr. Dre sometimes. It's like a random, like,
first, I want to talk about today, in this real talk, I want to talk about Tyler Creed.
Bowl and I went home for some damn adventure time with you. I slipped myself some pink Xanax, danced around the house and all.
First off, anyone in here who doesn't like Tyler? I don't think anyone in here doesn't like Tyler.
I think that nigga over there
don't like Tyler. He don't understand shit.
Nah, but, so, first off, I'm going to ask, like, anyone in here, what's their favorite album from Tyler? Like, they're all,
there we go.
Their best one.
Well, I like Bastard the most.
You like Bastard?
Cause like,
so y'all niggas can hold hands, that's cool.
I think it was the timing for me though.
Shit, I'm going with Wolf. That's my favorite.
That shit fire.
That's
fuck
my
favorite. Yeah, fuck
with that. My top one is Wolf too.
Like, bro, this nigga answer, wait, this nigga open his mouth. What's your favorite album?
The GOAT. Goblin.
Really?
Yeah. No, but I do agree, because I was talking to kids about that. I had Bastard above Goblin.
Yeah.
And it was a second for me. But now Goblin's ahead of Bastard. And
Goblin's second for me easy.
Yeah, because I mean, Goblin's a masterpiece. It's just the tracks in there and how he puts everything together.
Yeah.
Like, just like sound, lyrics, the story, and just how he did it. Like, my favorite track on there is the last track, I think. But it's like,
which one is that?
Golden, yeah. Mm. And the one before that, what's the track before that?
About Window?
Yeah, Window. Window before, that's when he kills everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone off. And then he got that instrumental after. And it's just like, that's how you know everybody's dead. Yeah.
I think Tyler is pretty genius for wanting to follow his inspirations, but going a step above. He loved like Nerd and Pharrell albums, like In Search of Himself, but he went a step above that shit. He was like inspired by the beats that Pharrell and Hugo and then made, but then he threw a better way of storytelling into it. I'm not knocking anything Pharrell does, but because I love Pharrell, but Tyler loved that shit so much, he was like, how can I take this and do it my way? And he did it in a way where you can't be like, oh, this isn't similar to Eminem's Kim, because I just heard that shit today. I read the whole Marshall Mathers LP while I was in the gym today. Mm-hmm. But listening to Tyler in the way he kills people is different than Eminem and how he killing people. It's completely different.
Because I think we mentioned Tyler in the last video with Everett, and someone commented and was like, well, Tyler created, like, it's just his sheer creativity, everything that he does. But I mean, I was telling Kenneth, he's doing things like with music that not many people are doing. And not just music. Just as an artist, like, you know, he did a carnival, like,
that's random.
Yeah, it's random. He did a carnival, and he's like, and he has an app, and he's, you know, he has all the
cooking show.
Yeah,
you know, the cartoon.
He has another show.
Yeah,
coming out in August.
Yeah, on Viceland.
For real?
Yeah,
that's dope.
It's on his app. Well, a couple of people on his app.
Yeah,
I think he's trying to figure out how certain things were made. It's called Nuts and Bolts or something like that.
That is pretty dope. Because Tyler's doing everything pretty much he wants to do. And like I said about Childish Gambino, he's using what he did first, what he put out with music, to leverage him as what he actually wants to be. He likes, like, he wants to be a director. He likes to do shit like that, but people don't take him seriously as that. And he was telling people in his songs that,
yeah,
like, I can do shit. So he made his music. he didn't want it to be taken that seriously.
Yeah.
People wanted to fuck with his shit.
Yeah.
So he's like, you know, I'm gonna use this.
Yeah.
And he used it through the carnival, made the app, the you know, the clothing line.
Yeah.
The Loiter Squad. Fucking hates MTV for not taking that shit. Like, honestly, that man Tyler, it's not like you have to really research deep about the steps he took in his life, because he makes it pretty apparent in his music. Like what he does, and it's crazy about it. He makes it apparent how he feels about the way people give him feedback. Like people, you know, the one that hit me like the most was when he was on Rusty, his verse on Rusty. That just, I can listen to that over and over again, because he doesn't give a fuck about what people think, but he wanted to tell people finally. Like he said, he thought I wasn't there until I threw a carnival, huh? And like he said something about, you didn't think I like gays, but Frank is on to my son. He was just, he was over that shit.
Yeah.
He's like, that was his point, like, all right, I'm gonna tell people, you need to stop talking shit, because I'm not my persona that I'm putting, you know, in my songs. He ain't Wolf, he ain't Sam, he ain't, you know, all these characters that aren't his albums, and it's crazy.
Hey, what it means to me, he don't do drugs.
Exactly. The worst thing, like your boy did, was eat a roach.
Hold up. That's real. I personally don't believe he ate that shit. For one, because like you know, Cameron Tracy, like they moved away. He moved really fast.
Blurred out.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like I just feel like even if he did, say he did eat a roach, that's the worst thing he did. Eat a roach. Like it's crazy. But he did make a little story out of that, because he brings it up later about.
Confronting
a bunch of parents in court like that. Yeah.
Saying,
you know,
I wasn't
president
that day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, man, that fool's crazy.
That's creativity, bro.
Say, and that's one of my favorite songs off book, too. Cowboy? Fire.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
I love Jabba, too. He said him and Haji took like 5 minutes to make that beat. I was like, why do I like a 5 minute beat so much? I was like, how?
I see that.
Because it was like super simple.
I think he actually did eat that plate too. He couldn't take that shit.
That's crazy. I respect that though. Because like, I feel like every artist has to do that one thing that just makes them stand up.
Actually, you won't know until we personally ask.
True. That's true.
Yeah.
Like, did you eat that down? Because I can see him doing some nasty ass
shit. Mm-hmm. He pushed like his boundaries. He wasn't even at the level to do some shit that he did in that video Yonkers. That's why they never showed the whole video on MTV when it used to come on, because he hung himself at the end. That was controversial, but he didn't give a fuck. He's like, this is what the song is about.
Right.
Acting some of his words and try to shit.
But it's crazy because that song that ain't supposed to be on the album.
Oh, Yonkers?
Yeah, when he said he was rapping like Jada Kiss on that shit.
Oh, he said he was trying to make a New York beat or
something. Yeah, him and Vince Staples was fucking around on the beat. I want to hear that shit.
Yeah, like a video of it, like that would be dope.
But I'm saying, if you look into Yonkers, like if you look into Yonkers, actually, you're gonna learn some shit. I ain't gonna say it because they can go and do their searches and shit about that. But like if you actually look up Yonkers, then I'm like, damn. If he did what I think he did with that song and that music video, it's even more genius than that.
I don't even know what the fuck
you're
talking about.
Now he wants to know.
No, I'm saying so people that fuck with Tyler, they can go and look it up and shit.
Alright. I'm curious. I want to know what the fuck you're talking about too. I have an idea.
Well, no, because the speculation that when he was a Yonkers, well, there's like in the same aside. In Yonkers, New York.
That's
why before the track comes in, he said, oh, so I heard you go to New York. Did he have to kill himself in a music video?
Now they know.
Well, they can go look into it and see if I'm bullshitting or not, but it's not like proof he actually did it, but it's like if he actually did go that route.
Yeah, that's deep.
It was hype track. That's why he was talking about it. Colossus, Yonkers. Sick of hearing about Yonkers. Like, that's crazy. People was really calling to him like, oh, it's my favorite track. Like y'all listen to any other of my, like, any, like, other of my shit, you know?
But it's just that it sucks because when you look at it, Yonkers is in like his top 20 tracks.
No, like, definitely, for sure. Like, honestly, I'm willing to be bold and say like top 15.
I would say top 10. I'm throwing a lot of goblins.
I'm throwing a lot of songs over it because I just like it personally, but I think song-wise, being made, story, like Yonkers, that's...
He don't really got too much to choose from, though. I mean, he has a body of work, but like, what? four albums, really.
And most people aren't even counting that.
Yeah.
That's it. What's that? Goblin?
And you got your damn mind for counting that, so it's disrespect.
Like, everyone likes Wolf. I get it.
Wolf is dope because of just the
just that it's the third best album.
Yeah, how you put it together. I love Cherry Bomb.
He changed directions too, though. He went from being like dark and all like talking about rape or whatever, you know what I'm saying? To being more like funk. Wolf is kind of funky if you think about it. It's real like live instrumentation. Mm-hmm. It's real like.
It's real super experimental, and like the story behind it too is about like his character, like, you know.
The best song on there is.
Yeah. Asking or
I'm not gonna tell it.
Well, what he said? He said the best song on there is
on Wolf 48. That's crazy.
Shit, my favorite that's song on side. Wolf. Damn, that's hard.
Mine
man.
Is on.
You already know because he likes pig. That's his favorite track on there. I'm going with Rusty, bro. That verse kills me, man.
See, but like the whole song, though.
Yeah, because I like Earl's verse too.
But Damo, it's like, I mean, the song's dope, but it's like sometimes I don't want to hear Damo and Earl's verse.
Yeah, I know, but I put up with it because they didn't go Haji on it. I mean, Haji and Tyler alone was cool, but when you, like, I don't like, and I ain't disrespecting Haji, but I don't really fuck with, like, Mixtape Volume 2, like lean and shit, like Haji and like with the, I'm like, damn.
Haji. I like when Haji raps with Dom.
Yeah, when Haji raps with Dom or Tyler, he sounds dope as fuck.
But like, I used to listen to Haji, like in the end of tapes and shit.
I personally never really went out to listen to Haji just rhymes.
But I had.
That's why he feels so disrespected. That's why Haji was low-key mad at Tyler. He felt disrespected, but it had nothing to do with Tyler. Tyler was always his homie, but people just happen like Tyler better than Haji. Like,
well, I mean, that's most people. Like, when you think of OF, you think of Tyler, you think of Earl. Mm-hmm. And people forget Frank was a part of the group.
Yeah.
No one's thinking Haji. Even though he does bar at times.
Yeah.
Like Damo, who I like more than Haji.
Oh yeah, of course.
Hey, this is low-key of like a tangent. What happened to Casey Vegas?
Well, he was
I haven't heard from him in a while.
Like, what happened to him, like, as of being in the group?
No. I'm just saying, like, music-wise. Because he was technically a part of
the group. Yeah, he was fresh.
Another one?
They dropped that.
Fresh Vegas.
But he's been gone for a minute, though.
Well, he dropped that album, what, a year ago?
Alright, wait, so when y'all listen to Tyler, what are y'all listening for? Me, I like production first and foremost. Like, that's why I like bachelor's.
Damn. See,
hey, he's like, why are you looking at me, bro?
He's like me, like I listen. Some people like, how you fucking with this song? Like, this rap is trash. Like, I love like beats, I love music, bro. I can completely ignore lyrics if I wanted to, but I don't with Tyler. But I listen for a production. Like, I love Cherry Bomb because of that. Yes. But I love Wolf because it has both production and mix.
I listen to Tyler for raps. Because, like, when you first listen to the song, you don't know who made the beat.
Well, I mean,
no,
if you're a Tyler fan, though.
Well, no, I'm saying that when you first heard Kanye, you didn't know Kanye made the beat.
Oh, sure, absolutely.
Exactly. And then you're like, oh, he made the beat. That's even better. Like, Mac Miller. No one knew who Larry Fisherman was until he said, that's me.
Right.
Mine's is more complex, because like, when I first went to listen to it, mine was for, like, sound, but more so when I go back and listen to it, it's for structure, like storytelling, how he puts everything together, every album and every track and, you know, every rhyme that he puts.
How'd you get, like, introduced to Tyler?
Through Trent. First time I heard it was in the living room, Yonkers. He was playing it.
I forgot why I was bumping.
Yeah, and then soon after.
Oh, I know why.
I never listened to Goblin all the way through, though.
Yeah.
It wasn't until after I heard, because Wolf is probably the first album I heard all the way through first.
Word.
And then after I heard Wolf, I heard Bastard, I fell in love with.
Word.
And Bastard was like my favorite. Oh yeah, he played, he was singing, he said even the intro.
I love the intro.
That shit was tight.